But in Dorset, I tracked down someone who had found a place to run to. Electrosensitive Adrian Gray has made Lyme Regis his refuge.
The first time I was affected by my mobile phone, I sent a text and it was as if something was running through my head. I couldn't believe that I could feel the message as I sent it.
Adrian believes that by removing himself from the modern world, he built up a resistance to the things that were causing him harm. He says it was moving into a tent that cured him.
I moved into the yurt in July 2004, and I stayed here for 8 months. And I had a futon on the floor. I had my clothes hooked onto the hazel around the edge. I had a little office set up on a trunk, and it was in my friend's garden, so I had a telephone line going in there. It was a tough time, because obviously the change of circumstances was quite difficult, and I took myself away from anything that was harming me, and so I kind of look upon it as something that helped me on the road to recovery.
Having recuperated, Adrian searched for more permanent accommodation. His new home has no electricity at all.
The whole house runs on gas. I have gas lights. Then over here, we have my phone, which is made by a company in Germany.
It makes phones for people with electrical sensitivity.
And then over here, in the kitchen, we have a little gas fridge. It keeps everything cold and works really well.
Adrian is now one of the few electrosensitives in the country who still holds down a job.
I have an adventure holiday company and it's internet-based, and before I used to do all the work on the computer myself. Now that I'm electrically sensitive, I can't spend long enough on a computer. So we have an office where we have two people working for us. I write out the emails in longhand. They get typed out by a lady in the local village.
That's emails for you.
Okay. And good. Everyone comes out of the office and they give me the paperwork, and it works very well. People do think that you're depressed, and you are depressed. One, you've got an illness that no one understands. You're probably completely broke because you can't do the job you used to do. You're pissed off because you can't live in the house you used to live in. Your whole life is turned upside down. I'm not surprised people get depressed. It's a bloody awful thing, and that's belittling it. If you change your environment and stop exposing yourself to whatever is harming you, then you just go back to being how you were before, back to, you know, a normal person. I live a very simple life now compared to a lot of people. I obviously don't have any electricity around me. I don't watch TV, I don't use computers. And I'm pretty happy, actually. In fact, I'm very happy.
My final visit is with a woman who claims to have one of the most extreme cases of chemical sensitivity and electrosensitivity in the world. These were the instructions she left for our meeting. Wear cotton clothes that you have been preparing by soaking in bicarbonate of soda. This can take 2 or 3 washes. Fill up with petrol or diesel the day before and not on the way, so you don't bring any petrochemicals with you. I will send you some special soap and shampoo.
Wash immediately after removing your clothes.
When you arrive, I will give you overalls that you can put over the top of your clothes, just in case. No deodorants, perfumes, mobiles or radio mics. She was diagnosed almost 25 years ago. For the last 11, she's been living in a wooden hut in a field in Somerset. In all that time, she's not been further than the end of her garden lane.
Good to meet you.
Yes, you found us. Welcome to my humble abode, as they say.
I should think the last time I went to a shop with the portable oxygen must have been at least 15 years ago. If I could even be got to a shop and survived the journey, it would give a whole new meaning to the phrase shop till you drop.
Despite a decade of isolation, Gillian's condition hasn't improved. She believes that's because the place she's living in is toxic. A former holiday home, it has no heating, it doesn't always have water, it's mice infested and it leaks.
Before I show you round my humble abode, I have to switch the mask on first.
Gillian feels the need to protect herself from chemicals still lingering on our clothes. She even airs books before she can read them.
Basically, in the porch here, any paper that comes into the place has to be outgassed on average for about 6 months. And so we hang it out here. I'll take you into the next part now. I'm going to stand away from the aluminium because it bounces my own electrical fields back at me and makes me collapse. We basically take in and bounce back the electric field, as it were, and muck things up. And most electrically sensitive people find that equipment breaks down all the time around them. Now, normally you would have a haven or sanctuary or refuge. People use a different term. And this is it. This is supposed to be my bedroom. This telephone's on this arm, but I don't like to be any closer to it than that. And I've got it covered in the EMF fabric. This is the bathroom. The thing I most want in the world is a hot bath.
It might be easy to dismiss Gillian. At first, she might seem a little eccentric. But then what would you be like if you hadn't left the house for 10 years? Gillian believes her illness was caused by exposure to agricultural chemicals. Back then, she was a biochemist and one of the UK's top experts on horse nutrition.
All I have ever wanted to do since early childhood is work in the agricultural industry and have horses as a hobby. I want to get back to that. But instead, I'm held in an incommunicado and limbo that is agonising, demoralising, and, it's just a half-life of despair, basically.
Gillian says she's been trying to persuade the local council to build her a house that could be a prototype for all sufferers of multiple chemical sensitivity. 10 years on, and she's still desperately holding out for the house she believes will point the way to the future.
This is a growing problem and it's not going to go away. They could be learning from the vanguard, people like myself.
Medical opinion may be against them, but those who say they suffer from chemical and electrical sensitivity believe they are simply the first to fall victim to an epidemic that will one day affect us all.
I feel the future is very bleak with the impact of electromagnetic radiation. We're already experiencing levels 30 million times more than we are evolved to deal with.
People have been increasingly referring to people with MCS as the canaries of the 20th and 21st century because of the miners' canaries, which used to be used to warn them of toxins. If the canary fell off the perch, they ran for it. We're being ignored.
We don't know that the electrosensitives are the unlucky ones, because it's all the people who are completely senseless who may ultimately prove the price. And what electrosensitives are doing are simply responding to their bodies saying, get the hell out of here.
Next Thursday night at 9, discover the truth about your food. Next tonight, twice the laughs in a comedy lab double bill.